Hi guys, I wasn't going to make a video here, but I decided what the hell, since it was easier than I thought. I'm just going to show you how to get the front fascia off of your car. It's a lot easier than it looks, even easier than the GTIs I used to do. Let's go through it. First thing I do, you do not need to take off the front tires. I jack it up. I use this square here in between the plastic. It's solid metal. After that, I put a jack stand up right where this little loop is in the plastic. Nice place for the frame. So get both sides up off the ground. And you're going to start taking bolts out of your fender here. What you'll have is a regular screw up here, which goes into here. You will have small tipped clips and the large tip clips. The two small clip tips go in the bottom. The two bottom ones are the small clipped. Everything else would be the higher areas. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, looks like 5. So I would have done 1, 2 up here, 3 over here, 4 down there. There is one more, if I could find it right now. But, so you undo those 5 clips also. Then you can just peel this back enough to get to a bolt, which is through here in your fascia. Once you pull that bolt off, you pull the bumper up, like back, so it gets over this little nub, and then it pops right out of these clips. Just like probably a lot of other cars, same way the VW works. And that's one side. You do want to watch your fog lights cords here. They're kind of tight. I'm not going to move it too much. I may disconnect this, but I'm being real careful about the pressure on them. Then you would do, you got 5 or 6, maybe 7 bolts along the bottom here. Just go all the way across, remove those. Then do the ones on the other side, your other fender well, and then everything's loose. For the top side with your cup holders, those just snap right off. So you just gently keep pulling up until your two cup holder covers come off of the top. And then the last four, or these four on top, I'd actually do these first, but it depends what order you go in, which are my 4 snaps here. So once you've done 4 top, 5 or 6 along the bottom, all the fender side ones I showed you, I just pull and it just comes right out. It's that simple. So you're probably gonna ask, why the hell am I removing the fascia on my brand new car? Leased car, no less. Well, you guys have bridge toll transponders out there through the world. I got this bumper style bridge toll transponder, which is the one I always prefer. I don't like the big square white ones we have in California sticking on your window. It looks like crap, basically. So I've always used these. I just throw it in the glove. But I have had success in some of my Wranglers where I put that under plastic in the front somewhere, and it always works. The only reason this won't work somewhere in the front is if there's metal above it. Here we have the perfect situation. Plastic bumper. I'm going to look for something under here, some way to put it in. Under here with the plastic, no metal busting it. Just tie wrap it up there. Then it's a permanent bridge toll. Don't have to pull it out every time I do it. And I'm gonna go look at placement options now. Little tip on your bulbs. You don't need to undo all this harness. You just twist it 90 degrees and it comes out. Also, don't forget you have one clip only on this side, which just goes into a little spot on your fascia to hold it in place. So, looks like I'm gonna go right here at this little indent, and this is an indent here. Right there in the center, no metal above it. Tiny pinholes there, nobody will ever see. Some tie wraps tight. That should be permanent. And hopefully it will not get in the way of anything as I slide it on. If so, I'll have to think of something else here. So looking down, this is the top of the fascia. I have it face down with the grill here. So see, you had these? I trimmed these two in the middle down for a perfect fit. I have my two holes drilled. I flatten it right there. I'm gonna do a double tie wrap on both because, of course, safety. If one ever snaps, two for sure, you got it. So all I got is my holes there. I'm just gonna tie wrap them both in real tight. This part is has so much room. This is the tip which goes on the metal. So there is nothing that should interfere with this section here. I'll find out as soon as I slide it back on. It's connected now. As good as stock, super solid. Used one large tie wrap and one small tie wrap. It's not going anywhere. Everything back on perfectly. No damage, no scratches. You just take your time, use a lot of towels and safety. Nothing's gonna happen. Incidentally, that special transponder, it's probably obvious, but those holes are license plate width. So technically, it goes on your front of your license plate, but that looks terrible too. So if you talk to your toll place, you can just ask them if they have any license plate mount stuff, and then you might find one of these, which are a lot more stealth and cool. I have it right under here. You can't even see it back here, it's too dark. But it should be perfect, and I'm gonna find out the first time I go through and try it. One final tip on this bolt that you hook in before you put this fender liner back. I had a little squeak here. So the tip is, put pressure on this as you tighten that bolt before you even get to the headliner part. Put pressure in, make sure there's no play. Then it's not gonna squeak like it was for me. So I just loosened it, pushed, held pressure on it, and tightened it back up. Just a step to save you trouble in the future.